final project, I found out about this steel mill on the East Coast in this small town called Redcar. And the steel mill closed down about 4 years ago. And I thought it'd be really interesting to make a film about that. It particularly resonated with me quite personally because Lancashire also has a similar history. It was cotton, the cotton industry in Lancashire, which was the dominant industry for, 150 years or so until the 90s. With the steel mill, I was really interested in the idea of this, both this industry and this town and community in decline, and in trying to tell that story as best as I could, and also in the cinematic possibilities of that, of filming on the East Coast, which can have some, you know, great scenes.
I worked many years in different steel plants throughout the north, and then I got into oil and gas in 1980 and offshore wind in the 2002. I was very lucky that I was never out of work, but I love being in construction, because the great thing about construction is you see something from a line on a drawing. So if it's a module, you see it sailing away. If it's a blast furnace, you leave it complete and then someone comes along and powers it up. So you see something for your fruits of your labour. And that was the greatest thing I had in my lifetime of working, is seeing something that I've been involved in personally come to fruition.
That was my initial idea, and I teamed up with initially just one other person for that, and then two more people came on board with the idea as well, and together we just went and made the film. And we had a few access issues with getting people in the film, so initially in the start we were just filming the landscape and trying to get a sense of what the community was like and what the area is like and what it looks like cinematically, and the best way to tell that. And then when we finally got some breakthroughs with the access, we went and filmed those guys, and they had some fantastic stories. And so that was really what we built the film around, just a collection of their stories and then a collection of the area as it looks today, and to sort of build it into this kind of poetic documentary about this area, and almost a bit of an oral history piece as well.
His shop was soon shut, his work was cut. Fire in the hearth, it fell frozen. The man came to speak, and he said in 1 week that number 11 was closing.
We worked together on the dissertation film, and I think we were able to bring, especially from the independent filmmaking module, our own styles and so on, and we were able to see from all the modules previously that we would work well together. So we made a film, an observational documentary about a family.
I'm not sure if there's anything you can do about it. There's a button on my stomach which keeps on popping.
Oh my god, okay.
When we started planning the film and we met Brandon and his family, we kind of thought that we might take a different road because Brandon had just had a really bad injury and was recovering from it. So we kind of thought that we would follow this road to recovery narrative. But after spending more time and building this relationship with the family, we were able to make a film which I think felt kind of almost more profound because it really ended up being about the relationship between Brandon and his mother and kind of the love that she has for him and the devotion both of them have to his figure skating and how hard they work.
姑娘是这样的姑娘，兽也是这样的兽，所有的我们都是如此的造物。我们仰着头，等人来抱着我们，问：你爱我吗？
Together, we made a film about a Chinese writer who recently moved to England and started writing in English. And the writer lives in Norwich, but I first met her in Leeds during a writer's event. And during that event, she talks about her confusion of cultural identities and being a first-time mother, like how she copes with writing and looking after the baby. And then I was thinking about like we can discuss the issue of cultural identity because we are both like from another culture and settling in England, and but then when we traveled to Norwich to actually meet her, we found out her struggle as a mother is probably a bigger issue than cultural identity.
Did it? No, okay. Now we did it. Over. Let's park. Now. Because last semester, I've been writing a lot about stories that took place in Ireland. And I thought this semester I wanted to write something different, maybe just to go hardcore Chinese. So I'm just trying to do more of a Chinese things. Yeah. It's about, say, classic Chinese culture and, like, classic Chinese literary people, like Song Dynasty Chinese literary people, and then the dynamic. It's just quite, I don't know. I don't know if that's transferable. I mean, if that could be expressed properly in English. But that's the challenge, I suppose. It would be very strange to them, so I want to see how it works, I suppose. We got it, Killian. Oh, hello.
Yeah, I think it's a good vibe to become a friend with her at first. So we met her without any equipment. So yeah, it let us think that we're not just a filmmaker, it's just a friend of her and recording her life. And yeah, I like how we going to her house in the morning, like every 8 o'clock and follow her till the whole day for a week,
yeah. Jew is like a pun, Jew is like everything, but also the pronunciation of Jew of pig. So it's kind of like a pun. So Jew is really wearing that.
What a man. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not within temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
My film this year was about a spiritualist church in Newcastle. It was about 15 minutes long, I think. And it's sort of, I think over about 3 or 4 months, we were going into this church and filming, meeting the people, talking to them. And we didn't really go in with an idea of what it was going to be about. We sort of just knew about this sort of niche community that, you know, that we knew nothing about, basically. So it was more of an exploration, which again, I think is more interesting than sitting writing about something, because every day that we went in, that was our research, and we were speaking to people, and it was interesting, and it was like personal.
Comfort the family, right. All right? And she's coming in with a lot of love for you, right. And the understanding of what you've been through, mm-hmm. in the last 6 to 12 months. Can you understand that?
Yes.
Now I want to give you the colour yellow for inner peace. All right. Now that inner peace has got up and gone quite a long time ago, and it's just gradually starting to come back into you.
Yes.
All right. But I also want to say there is also a lot of purples and lavenders around you. That is for the healing you need at this moment in time. Now, when we talk about healing, it's not always because we've got heart problem or cancer or this, that, or the other. Sometimes it's just because we're stressed a bit. All right. So just remember, it's a new beginning. So it's up to you whether you take that right. on board and go forward, all right?
Yeah, I was director-producer, so I was doing a lot of the interviews and everything, and then practicing a lot of the skills that I'd learned earlier on in first year when we were like learning about interview techniques, which again, I didn't really realize at the time until you're reflecting on it, and then you sort of realize that, wow, when I was coming to uni, I would never have had the confidence to go into a church that I'd never been to and just like plonk myself in there and start interviewing them and asking them quite personal questions about death and everything else.
The healers, a channel for spirit to be able to come through us and to the patient in front of us and going to exactly where it's needed.